So hi dudes, Alex Forrest vlogging to you at a massive, probably the biggest shopping centre in Europe actually, in Warsaw, Poland. And the Christmas spirit has taken hold. I've just come out of the shopping centre having done a little bit of Christmas shopping. It's absolutely teeming in there, and it's only what, 6th, 7th of December? Now, you may be thinking, like, if you're a bit of a grumpy old sod like me, oh God, bloody hell, Christmas, here we go, the Christmas shopping. You know, it can actually be a real tonic. Take a fresh perspective on Christmas and the Christmas shopping adventures that you are going to have to go on in order to please your mother. Because here there is a golden opportunity, completely free of charge, to, you know, meet the female population of the world in your city. Because, you know, it's just full of lovely girls shopping, full of the Christmas spirit, and you will find that things are a little bit more relaxed, a little bit more chilled sometimes. I've made two approaches today, one in a coffee shop earlier this morning, got the number and she's just texted back, and the other one, a beautiful tall girl in a short kind of tanned leather miniskirt with boots, and she had these big glasses. I just had to open her. She had long black hair, quite tall, gliding through the Christmassy undergrowth of this shopping centre. I had to open up a conversation. And my opener, and you will be familiar with this little trick, I think it's really crucial, is to open with an observation. And in this instance, you reminded me of Jamie Lee Curtis, who's got that sort of smart hot look. A girl likes to know that she's not just attractive, but she's actually smart. And I told her that she looked intriguing right at the end of the conversation. We exchanged contact details. Another key thing is we held hands for what seemed like an eternity. She had tattoos on every finger, and I held her hands to look at them. And, you know, making that physical contact is a really positive thing. If a girl lets you hold her hand, I eventually was the one to pull away. Anyway, so there it is. Spin the gloomy Christmas present buying expedition you're gonna have to go on into a positive by using it as an opportunity to approach girls. And as I've said previously, I find myself more and more often these days approaching girls just as I'm going about my normal day-to-day. It just feels so much more genuine. And I think once you've got over the hump of, you know, approaching, you know, 1,000 girls, let's say, then it's time to dial it down a little bit and be more natural. You've picked up the skills to trust you've got them. And if your fortune is with you, like it has been with me recently, you know, two approaches and two solid telephone numbers. Okay, I'm going to talk this afternoon about that interesting twilight zone in between the daytime and the nighttime, which obviously, when it's winter, there's, you know, far more opportunity to approach girls in the evening. It's going to get dark a lot earlier. And a lot of day gamers may think, well, I'm a daytime approach guy. I don't do bars and clubs. Well, fine. I mean, late night clubs and bars, you know, that's a whole different night game territory. But there is this beautiful magic hour, you know, 5, 6, 7 on a Thursday, Friday evening maybe, when you can really quite easily adapt your daytime approach skills to the evening time. Yeah, so this is like evening approach. I'm going to just give you a couple of little anecdotes of some approaches that I've made of girls during this period and the way that they differ from the standard model. Have a look at Approach Basics 1, which I'll link at the end of this vlog. The first incident is actually a girl that I'm dating right now. I've been on 4 or 5 dates, and I went to a function in the city of Warsaw. It was an actors and performers musicians club. I went there for a tango dancing event that had been run by the Polish language school I attend. And after the event, everyone trickled off into the night at about 10 o'clock, and I just had just decided to stay on a little bit longer, as I'd seen a girl that I was attracted to, and she'd given me an IOI, an indicator of interest, as they say in PUA circles. And so I got myself a gin and tonic. I sat down on the table. She was with a friend, turned out to be her flatmate, and I just chilled. I just sort of, and sometimes this is kind of, you know, really important, just was happy to be in my own skin, on my own, at 10 o'clock in a bar. This was in the summer, incidentally. It was outside. And I was very nervous because obviously, you know, the longer you leave it, the harder it gets. Except, you know, there is no general, rigid rule about these sorts of things. Sometimes you do have to bide your time and wait for the right moment and wait for an opening. And it came when her friend got up and went to the bar to get them more drinks. Here's the thing, okay? I went up to this girl and I said to her, look, I just had to come up and say hello. I saw you earlier and I think you look very nice. And what I noticed about you was your crazy spangly dress, which is basically, I don't know, giving me all sorts of kind of like a narcotic sort of hallucinogenic experience just watching you in your crazy dress. So it went something like that. And that was kind of magical. That got her talking about the dress and about she was interested in fashion, she was interested in marketing, and that just broke the ice. And then there was this little beautiful bubble of conversation. Her friend came back, by which point actually this girl had invited me to sit down and join them. And then it was just like I spent 30, 40 minutes with them bantering, basically, and then took her number and left. She was quite eager in the end to give me her number. It was a really very positive sign. Now, the other anecdote happened to me actually a couple of years ago. I was in a bar in Covent Garden with another very experienced day game who was kind of showing me the ropes in terms of hitting on girls during the evening. And he said, look, you know, you can, Alex, just be quite honest and direct. You're here with me, you've got the social proof. If you see a girl, just peel off and go and open up a conversation and be very clear and honest when you present yourself to her. So I went over to this girl who sat down with her friend in a corner of a bar, and I just stood at this table and I told her she looked like a glorious flamingo because she was quite tall. And I said to her, look, I just had to come over and say hello and I'd like to get to know you better. Do you like some company? So I actually was, which is exactly what I wanted to do. I wanted to sit down with her, have a drink, have a conversation, flirt with her and get to know her better. And I just quite clearly sort of stated that. And I was astonished when, bing, she said, yeah, cool, sit down, invite your friends over. And so my buddy joined me and, you know, we flirted and I got a telephone number. I think she was actually looking to meet up with us later on that night. She was like a proper, lovable Essex girl out on the town on a Friday night. But we had other plans, so that particular number never went anywhere. That's often a problem in a nighttime situation. Girls just looking for a bit of fun and adventure. So those are the two anecdotes, and I think, you know, it goes without saying that the trick here was, number one, dial back, pull back on the compliment. When you're in a shopping centre, you can tell a girl she looks stunning or beautiful. And I told this girl in this shopping centre she looked like a smart, hot Jamie Lee Curtis. Yeah, and in the daytime that works. But in the evening, that's a little bit too much. So in the first anecdote, you will have noticed that I made an observation that was a tease about her spangly dress. Yeah, and I didn't really pay her a proper compliment. She then started talking and got invested in the conversation and in me, and she invited me to sit down and join them. The second situation, again, you know, be really quite clear about your intent. And in that instance, you know, I just simply put my cards on the table. I told her that I wanted to come over and open up a conversation, get to know her better, and perhaps share a drink for a few minutes. Time constraint often helps in these situations. And bang, she was up for it. And what's significant here is, and the big difference, I think, often between the daytime approach and an evening approach, you know, is during the daytime, a girl's got stuff that she's doing. She might even be in a hurry to catch a bus or get to a meeting. Or she may have, you know, she may be married or engaged or have a solid relationship. In the evening, if a couple of girls are out, you know, perched on bar stools with glasses of wine, they are waiting for a guy to man up and approach them and open up a conversation. Now, I know often you will get a push and they'll say, I'm just here with my friend enjoying a drink, enjoying a glass of wine, go away. You know, you can get through that if you're a more experienced day gamer. But often you will find a girl, but often one of the two girls might have this sort of, I'm with a friend, particularly the one obviously who's not being hit on. So you do have to kind of manage that situation. But in both the examples I've given, you know, and this is generally the case, they are there to have fun, and providing you're a little bit calibrated, you know, you throw in a time constraint, and providing you're not too sort of gushy in terms of complimenting them, then they will happily, you know, hang out with you. And I think what was so interesting about both those anecdotes, I was just sort of surprised how easy it went. After the ice had been broken initially, I actually spent some quality time with them, got to know them better. And certainly in the case of the girl in the bar in Warsaw, got, you know, a solid number, and you know, I've been dating that, in the early stages at least, dating that particular girl. And, you know, she's a genuinely attractive girl too, and an 8 for my money. So don't be kind of fearful if you are if you've done a lot of daytime approach, don't be fearful about just widening the circle and making approaches during the evening as well. And also, you know, it's worth trying. I know it's hard, but try once or twice, just chilling out on your own, perhaps bantering with the barman, perhaps creating a little story for yourself, like I'm just waiting for some friends, or, you know, I've got a flight to catch, or I'm going to the theatre in 20 minutes and I've just got some time to kill, or whatever might make you feel comfortable so you don't feel like a lonely barfly, you know. And practice actually just being comfortable in your own skin, in your own company, and enjoying your own company, and you'll be amazed to see how the serendipity of the universe often provides you with opportunities in terms of approaching hot girls. Okay, so hopefully that particular silver bullet of wisdom, I prefer the metaphor of silver bullets of knowledge, or silver bullets of dating wisdom, than I do golden nuggets. And golden nuggets sounds like a little bit like sort of a YouTube channel that a wealthy older dude, a Russian dude, might run. I like the idea of silver bullets, werewolves, nighttime mystery, wild animalistic and masculine urges, and all of that good stuff. I have just bought out the Kindle version of Too Late Mate, second edition. It's an updated version, it's rewritten, it's a really good, strong, tight read now, with a fantastic cover by a celebrated cartoonist from California. So throwing a little bit of money on it as well. I will be bringing out print version in about a month, I reckon, in time for your Christmas stocking. And I've also just published Mysterious Duck Girl, which is a couple of stories in which I talk about generating sexual chemistry on the street during the daytime and how powerful that can be if you get it right. So yeah, I'll link the books and I'll link the Approach Basics 1 vlog at the as part of a title sequence as we fade out to some rather sort of wistful, bluesy, funky jazz trumpet music. Strap on your balls, you bastards. Get yourselves into the Christmas spirit. Get out there and approach girls.